just at the veranda there to get some sunlight and everything. Yeah, but I could not do anything. I could not eat. I'd grown so thin, man. It was months now. They had prayed, done everything, but it was not working, man. It was not working. Hey, what's up, Booker's gang? Hope you're doing good. If you're new here, it's your boy Brian Booker, and this is another video. So guys, I'd like first of all to thank you guys for always supporting me and always watching my content, always coming back to watch my channel. Yes, and if you haven't subscribed, man, what are you waiting for? Who are you watching? Yeah, subscribe to my channel right now. Yeah guys, as you can hear me, my voice is it's not that good. Yeah, I'm feeling kinda under the weather, but I'm fine. Yeah, hope you can still hear my voice very well. Yeah, because today I have a very hot video for you guys, man. As usual, as you all know, this is all I do, man. Just create for you nice content to enjoy, man. Yeah, so make sure you give this video a thumbs up, you comment, you like, and you share. Yeah, so guys, today I'm here with I can say it's a serious topic, or is it, I don't know what to call it. Yeah, but today I want to tell you a story of how I almost lost my life. Yes, how I almost died. Yeah, it's very serious, man. Yeah, and everybody who is outside there who thinks that witchcraft is not real, man, this thing is real and it's there. Yeah, it's happening. All you got to do is just to pray, man. Pray hard and don't believe in it, and yeah, it will not catch up with you. Yeah, so this is the story. The story took place, so it was a while back. Yeah, I was young. I was very young. Yeah, I got so sick. But this is how it all happened. Let me start the story from the top. So this day, we had just finished taking lunch, and my mom was clearing the table, and suddenly there was a knock at the door. Yeah, so when my mom went to open the door, it was our old neighbor who was at the door. It was weird, you know. It was very weird, because this is one person that we are not used to so much. And again, this is one person who had traveled long distance to come to our place. Yeah, and his reason was he had just come to say hi. Imagine, somebody you're not used to, and this person has come all the way. Yeah, and the worst part of it all, this person brought a gift, and the gift was brought me some chicken. Yeah, a live one. Yes, so that I could keep it for later. So, you know, in an African setup, when a visitor comes, even if they didn't say they were coming, they'll prepare something for them. Yeah, so my mom decided to make something for the visitor, but the first thing, my mom left this the piece of ugali that we had eaten just on top of the table, but it just left with, it didn't even go to the kitchen, and it did take even less than a minute. But when he came back, the ugali was not there. Where's the ugali? But he could not ask the visitor that, hey, where's the ugali? Yeah, okay, so she just assumed that maybe the visitor was so hungry and he had eaten the ugali that was on the table. So she just continued with her stuff, she first prepared some vegetables and ugali and everything. But then the visitors say that they don't eat vegetables with milk. Yeah, because my mom at that time used to cook almost every vegetable with milk. Yeah. So that my mom had to go and cook again. You know. Yeah. So my mom went to the kitchen to cook another vegetable. But when coming back after cooking, she realized that the ugali was not there again. Where is the ugali gone to? But the same night, I decided to ask the visitor, "Hey, man, where is the ugali?" The visitor said that he has eaten the ugali. Man, how can somebody eat a ugali that big in that short time? It was not logical. So my mom went and cooked another ugali. And now the visitors just wash his hands and everything. And imagine the visitor insisted to go and, you know how you can wash your hands inside a basin and then you pour out the water. Yeah, when you don't have a sink, something of that sort. That the visitor decided to go and pour the water by himself outside. It was very weird for my mom, but my mom just said, "Okay, if that's what you really want, then just do it." So he went outside, he poured the water on the doorsteps and came back, had his lunch. While catching up with my mom, you know, my mom is a very social person. Yeah, so they kept on talking as we were playing outside at that moment. Yeah, so after that, the visitor just went away. Yeah, but it didn't take time. Yeah, I just started growing so ill, man. It was very, 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 very sick. I got so sick. Yeah, I got so sick that I could not even move. I could not move. My hair was white. My hair just turned white. Like somebody with, do you call it marasmus or something? I was gone, man. Yeah, the jolly baby and very jolly and very, what do you call it? Very bubbly was no more. So my parents decided to take me to the hospital. Yeah. So my parents took me to the hospital first. Nothing, man. Nothing. We went to every hospital, nothing. They were screening me, but they were finding nothing. Blood tests, nothing, everything, every test they were trying to do, it was nothing. So, I was even admitted to the hospital, yeah. They were just trying at least to give my parents hope and everything, but really they were not, there's nothing that was being done because they were finding nothing. Even they were also surprised that, hey, what's really happening with this boy? Yeah. So I went to different hospitals. I went to the best hospital that my parents really sacrificed. You know how you can sacrifice for your child at least to get the best medication. So I was taken to one of the best hospitals, but nothing. Until my parents just they were giving up, man. Yeah. Imagine you have tried to treat your child. You have done everything until now you just decided to give up. Yeah. So I came back home. You know, my parents brought me home, man, because I could not be helped in any hospital. So my parents just brought me home that by the grace of God, by prayers and everything, maybe I shall recuperate and everything. But it was not happening. Every day it was getting worse, man. It was getting worse and worse and worse. Yeah, and the funny thing about this, all this story, the chicken that the guy brought to me, the gift, just got lost. Just when the guy, after the guy went, the chicken got lost. Imagine. The chicken just got vanished. He did come back. Yeah. But a few days later, we find the chicken, but it was rotten. Yeah. I don't know what had happened. The chicken was just gone. Yeah, rotten, man. So my parents were really worried. Yeah, so every day they used to just in the morning they take me outside at least to just at the veranda there to get some sunlight and everything. Yeah, but I could not do anything. I could not eat. I'd grown so thin, man. It was months now. They had prayed, done everything, but it was not working, man. It was not working. Yeah. Hey, so it was really stressful, man. Yeah. My mom was really stressed, you know. She was just like, she had lost hope. Yeah. My parents thought that I was going to die, but I was not dying, the funny part of it. I was just deteriorating very fast, yeah. I was thin at that moment. Even a simple wind could blow me away, man. I was gone, yeah. Just literally gone. And so, we were just seated. So one day, I was just outside, convulsing, very seriously. My mom was trying to, using a damp cloth to at least control my temperatures, but it was not happening. Yeah. So suddenly the news came to us. There's news. We had somebody who came to our house. She came with good news, though. Yeah. The thing is, the guy who we were suspecting had done this. The guy who took the food and everything. Yeah. He was dead now. But before he died, he was calling names and calling names of people we had really done ill to before. Yeah, begging for forgiveness and everything, you know. Man, imagine when that guy just died like this. Then everything that's changed. Yeah, everything that's just changed. Because imagine I stopped convulsing at that moment immediately, and I called my mom's name, man, and requested for some food immediately. Imagine I just requested for some food. Can you give me some food, mom? Wow, my mom was surprised, because all these months I was not eating well. They were trying to give me anything. I'm not eating and everything. But today I had requested for food, and the convulsion also had stopped. Hey, my parents were surprised. So my mom just rushed and brought me some food. And I just ate. Yeah. Man, I ate. I started getting little strength again. And I started eating well again. Yeah, and imagine in 2 weeks' time, I'd started gaining weight. Yeah, my hair was now back to normal, the normal color. Yeah, it was not that white. It was turning back. So, what I was imagining, suppose that guy didn't die. Yeah, suppose that did happen. Then I think maybe I'm the one who could have ended up dead. Imagine. But 2 weeks later, and my health just started coming back, man. I was now going back to my normal health. My parents kept praying and praying for me, and everything now was now working. The prayers were now working perfectly and everything. Yeah, man, I think it was the most stressful part of my life, yeah. Because, you know, when your kid is so sick and you're trying to do everything and they're not even responding, you know how stressful it can get, yeah. It is very stressful and very sad. So, at least my parents now decided, my mom got back to her job. My dad also resumed working, because now I was getting well. And surprising thing is, imagine that this guy's son came around just to check if I was I don't know what he was coming to check. Maybe he was coming to check if I'd successfully died. But that don't happen. And I always thank God for that, man. Yeah. I always feel like I was given a second chance in this world, yeah. That I should not take for granted. Yeah. And you guys, these things are true and are there, man. Yeah. The only thing you got to do is just continue praying. Pray so hard that he doesn't get to you or anything, any member of your family. And just don't allow strangers to get into your life, man. Just keep your life secret. It's not a must you tell people everything that is happening to your life, because some people are not even happy about them. Some people, even if you think are your friends, are not even happy about them. And yeah, it will come to harm you someday, even not to be successful in whatever you want to do because of that. So just do your thing, let them see you shining. Yeah, because it's not right for somebody to interfere with your life because they're jealous towards you, man. It's sad, it's bad, and it's one of the worst things that can happen to you. Yeah, but anyway, guys, years later, here I am, man, and so full of health and doing perfect. I never had such an incident again in my life ever. Yeah, and I'm perfect right now. And yes, I always pray and thank God for giving me that second chance, because I think I deserved it, man. Yeah. I was just a little boy who had not even, I had no grudge with anybody. Yeah. It was not the right thing to do. Yeah. But all in all, guys, that's the story, man. That's the day I almost lost my life. Not even a day. I was sick for months. Yeah. I could not move, I could not do anything. I was being carried. Imagine. So a child who could walk and do everything by himself, all of a sudden just becomes like a baby, and now you have to do everything for them. Yeah, it was hectic and it was crazy. But I thank God and I thank my family for supporting me and for always being there for me at that time. They didn't give up on me. Yeah, even if I left the hospital and came back home, my mom was always there for me. My siblings were always there for me. Yeah, always watching me and praying for me and everything. And I'm so grateful, guys, for everything. Yeah. It's the prayer that really gave me more life, gave me more light. At least I was able to hold on a bit. If my family wasn't prayerful, then I think maybe I could have been long gone now, man. Yeah, guys, so that's a very sad story that I wanted to share with you so that you can know that this life is crazy. Yeah, it's crazy, but either way, you have to continue living and you have to continue doing your thing, guys. Yeah, so guys, it was nice talking to you about this story today. And wherever you are, keep praying and keep just trusting your God that everything will be alright and you will be alright, guys. So, till next time,